Hello everyone and welcome back to Paul's Hardware. I'm Paul and I'm wearing a t-shirt with a graphics card on it, which makes me uniquely suited to analyze GPU prices, a thing I've been doing in this series since I brought it back in March. And I'm glad I did because for one, a lot of you guys had said, hey Paul, I'm glad you're doing this series. It really helps me keep up with the current GPU pricing. And thanks to those of you who have left me comments in the comments section. And also I've been able to pretty consistently bring you guys good news. And yes, there is even more good news this month. Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise. Tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. So the good news this month is there are even more GPUs just available at MSRP, which seems like it should just be a normal thing, but it wasn't for several months. But a quick note on my methodology for gathering the data for this video, I'm using PC Part Picker, and I'm looking at the lowest listed prices for any given GPU, such as the 5070 Ti. After verifying that the prices listed are not some shady third-party Amazon reseller, I'm taking the lowest 10 listings, and then gathering all that data onto this spreadsheet. For August, we have average price listings as well as the lowest price listings. I'm focusing a little bit more on the lowest prices. And then you can also see the history going back to July, June, May, April, and March. And I have removed some of the average price columns just so we can actually look at all this on one page. So feel free to pause and look at this more closely if you're interested, but the quick analysis for this month is that if you look at the RTX 50 series, which is NVIDIA's current generation, and you look at this column over here, price difference from versus MSRP, we have 100% or lower in every single category. Compare that to July, and you'll notice there's still quite a bit of red here, especially at the higher end for 5070 Ti, 5080, and 5090. So it is still very nice to know that things are moving in the right direction, and if we switch back to August, I can now say for anyone who is really holding out for a, I don't want to say a deal, but at least not overpaying for these higher end NVIDIA graphics cards, well, your wait seems to have paid off. So with that quick assessment out of the way, I'd like to give you my quick picks for if you're buying a graphics card, what graphics card should you buy right now for certain price ranges. Starting off in the more budget range, if you're gonna spend around $250 to $300 for a graphics card, my number one pick would be the 9060 XT 8GB. Even though the lowest price has gone up by $20, it was $250 last month. Now it's around $270. But at least that is directly available. You don't have to rely on a mail-in rebate or anything like that. You can purchase it straight from Amazon. It is in stock and ready to go. While this card does only have an 8GB VRAM buffer, it is at least $30 less than the 5060 8GB, and it should outperform both the 5060 8GB and the 5050 8GB. Now, if you want to get yourself a bit more VRAM in this price range, my number two choice is going to be Intel's Arc B580. There's at least a couple models of that available for $260, which is a little bit easier to stomach than when it was selling for $300 plus a month or two back. You are still paying more than what you should have to pay because these cards should be selling for $250, but it is the cheapest option you can buy at retail that has a more than 8GB VRAM buffer. My number three choice in this range is the RTX 5060 8GB. This has been steadily selling for $300 ever since it first came out on the lowest end, but the average price does continue to drop. I noted that 9 out of 10 of the listings I found this month, the cheapest listings, were at the $300 MSRP. So perhaps we might see an RTX 5060 8GB go below its MSRP sometime soon. Now, if you have a few more dollars to spend on your GPU, jump up to the $350 to $450 price range. Here, there are two recommendations. First, the RX 9060 XT 16GB. Unfortunately, this one's still selling for $10 over MSRP, but the lowest price has come down and it's now selling for $360 at the cheapest. And look, that's even being sold on the Newegg seller's website, but it's directly from the XFX official store for $360, ready to go. And the very nice thing there is you're gonna get a 16GB VRAM buffer, and the 9060 XT does typically outperform the 5060 Ti 16GB, which is my number two choice in this category. Unfortunately, pricing for the 5060 Ti 16GB is, at least it's MSRP, but it has been stagnant for the last 2 months. And here again, it would be nice to see this card dip down a little bit more because then it would be a stronger recommendation versus the 9060 XT 16GB. But very much so, if you're gonna spend this much money, don't sacrifice the VRAM. Don't consider an 8GB card. Because really, it's 2025, and you want to make sure you have the VRAM to support any future games you might play, especially if you're considering upgrading your monitor to a higher resolution, for example. If you have even more money and are going to spend between $500 and $600 on a graphics card, here my number one choice would be the RTX 5070 12GB. This one has steadily been available for its $550 MSRP, so not really much change there, although the average price has continue to drop down a little bit, so that's good to see. You do get a 12GB VRAM buffer. I would like to see more at this price range, but you have to pay a little bit more at this price range for 16GB. And that would be for my number two choice in this category, which is the RX 9070 16GB. If this was not selling for $50 over its MSRP, which should be $550, it would probably be number one over the 5070. But it is not, and sadly, here's where we have to give AMD another stern talking to or a slap on the wrist or what have you. Because while NVIDIA's prices have continued to come down and now we have MSRP availability pretty much across the board, AMD, particularly for the RX 9070 and 9070 XT, which we had such high hopes for, has not managed to get those prices down to a reasonable level. And it still just doesn't taste right to pay this much over MSRP. The 9070 XT 16GB should be $600 and it's still going for $700 to $735. But this is why if you go above the $500 to $600 price range, pretty much you get what you pay for. But at least you're paying MSRP. If you're gonna spend $750 on a graphics card, get the 5070 Ti 16GB. It is now available for its $750 MSRP. Same goes for the RTX 5080. If you're gonna spend $1,000 on a graphics card right now, the 5080 is pretty much your only reasonable option, I guess outside of the used market or something like that. But this video primarily deals with retail pricing. And then lastly, the 5090. If you're gonna spend $2,000, I'm not saying it's a good deal for $2,000, I wish it cost less than that, but at least it is not $3,000, we say, like a beaten dog returning to its owner. With the GPU market being what it is, we kinda have to take what we can get. Okay, rounding things out with sort of an overall view of the entire list, because I do start with the RTX 40 series here. If you guys haven't been following this series, the RTX 40 series from NVIDIA were discontinued towards the end of last year so they could switch production over to the RTX 50 series, which means these GPUs are not being produced. There is still inventory on the market, but there's not a lot, which is why the pricing for them is generally not good. As you can see, almost every single one is selling for above the MSRP, with the slight exception of the 4060 Ti 8GB, which came down to $390 this month, but really, if you're looking for an 8GB card, the 5060 8GB will get you by just fine for $300, or for even less money, just go for that previously recommended 9060 XT 16GB. So just to reiterate, don't buy RTX 40 series cards at retail right now, because they are not well priced, and there are much better options on the 50 series side. That doesn't mean you should write them off entirely. There are used market deals, it's just harder for me to assess those. If you can find a screaming deal, like I'd say something that's 70, 60% or less than the current lowest pricing, then take a look at benchmarks and see if that makes sense for you. But for anyone buying new right now, the RTX 50 series is pretty much gonna be the go-to, with the exception of those tier one and tier two recommendations that I've already fired off. And just a few things I noticed as I was going through this list, the 5060 8GB having 9 out of 10 models available for the $300 MSRP was nice. The 5060 Ti 8GB is the only card on the NVIDIA 50 series list that is actually selling for below the MSRP, but that is because it's an 8GB card that they're attempting to sell for $380, and lowering that makes the card slightly more competitive. Unfortunately, the cheapest versions here, the $340 options, are going to require a mail-in rebate. Mail-in rebates are not always redeemed. That's why companies use them, to try to sell cards for a price listing that seems less than what it actually is. If you're the kind of person who diligently turns in mail-in rebates, then perhaps that has some appeal to you. But the cheapest non-mail-in rebate discounted 5060 Ti is still going for $360, which is still $20 less than its MSRP. But I still do not recommend this card, because when you're paying about this much money, I'd much rather have that 16 gigs of VRAM and a card that performs much better in rasterization for pretty much the same price. For the 5060 Ti 16GB, which would be, again, easier to recommend if we got a little bit of a discount over the MSRP, but while the pricing hasn't changed much, there is sort of a benefit that you can buy one directly available for sale on Amazon. Last month, there was MSRP offerings as well, but you had to have a Prime subscription. For the 5070 12GB, while the price didn't go down, the lowest price didn't go down, the average price did drop more. Here we had 7 out of 10 of the cheapest models listed at the MSRP of $550. And then that brings us to the RTX 50 series cards that have had the most movement, starting with the 5070 Ti, down $40, bringing it to its MSRP. And I had in my notes that you didn't need a Prime membership for this listing, but you do need a Prime membership to get this Gigabyte Windforce
for the $750 MSRP. This PMY card was also MSRP and didn't require Prime membership, but now it's gone back up to $780. But if you search around just a little bit more, you can find listings that don't require something like a Prime membership. B&H, for example, has the ASUS 5070 Ti Prime for $750. Add to cart, ready to go. Look, it's even free shipping. And rounding things out, what is clearly evidence to me is that the RTX 50 series at the high end, perhaps sales weren't moving along quite as well as they had expected. We have a $300 base drop on the lowest price from $1,300 down to $1,000 for the RTX 5080. Here again, you might have to hunt around a little bit. ASUS was selling it directly for $1,000, but it's currently out of stock. Best Buy also had a $1,000 model, currently sold out as of the filming of this video. But again, with just a little bit of hunting, we found a Gigabyte Windforce RTX 5080 for $1,000. I guess you gotta pay $13 for shipping, so technically it's not right at $1,000. But there are at least a couple models that are right there. Personally, my personal opinion is between the 5070 Ti 16GB and the 5080 16GB, I don't think there's $250 worth of performance between the two of those, so if you're trying to find a better bang for your buck option, 5070 Ti at $750 I think would be my go-to over the 5080. And lastly, the RTX 5090. $2,000 is also still too much money, in my opinion, to pay for an RTX 5090, but at least it's not $2,600. Minus $600 to the 100% MSRP. And I think these retailers are gonna make me a liar yet again, because as I've refreshed this from the research mode to the filming the video mode, these are now showing as out of stock. But this is not the only model of the RTX 5090 that's popped up at the $2,000 MSRP this week. So if you can't find it right now, and if you really got your sights set on the 5090, I definitely recommend just being patient, keeping your eye on the listings, because while the next jump up is $300 more, that's a lot in terms of like just getting yourself one, because the next step up is $300 more, and that's a big bump. So hold out. We've seen multiple listings this week for $2,000. And in fact, while it wasn't on PC Part Picker, I just went and directly searched on Newegg, and oh, that's why, because it's out of stock. Wait, no, add to cart. May or may not be restocked, but I can add it to cart. We're in sort of an interesting little gray area there. But like I said, 5090s are coming in at the $2,000 MSRP. So good job, holdouts. You saved yourself $500, $1,000, $1,500, depending on when you were gonna buy before. And that rounds things out for GPU Price Watch 2025, our August entry. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm gonna post links to some of those GPU recommendations I have down in the description below. And while you're down there, there's also a link to my store at paulshardware.net where you can buy yourself shirts with graphics cards on them, like this. Lots of other high quality merchandise as well to help support the channel, and it is much appreciated. Thank you guys so much once again for watching this video, and we'll see you all in the next one.